banks very often are actually at the forefront of thinking about data and customer experience. Banks are actually pretty good at dealing with data, but what they don't want to do is be constrained anymore by dealing with very big hardware systems on-premise. They want to focus their precious resource to really solve and innovate customer problems. So the ability for them to do that and remove that heavy lifting that's required when you run data centers and leverage these new building blocks is of crucial importance. So for example, we see companies like Banco Fibra here in Brazil who have actually closed their data centers now and lifted and shifted into AWS and are now leveraging that huge benefit of not running data centers. That allows them to innovate much faster on behalf of their customers.
You mentioned Fibra Bank here in Brazil. And what is the current stage of banking moving to the cloud today in Brazil and globally, if you can?
We really see every financial market and area looking to leverage AWS, really to fundamentally positively affect customer outcomes for them. So globally, you've got the likes of HSBC, Capital One, Barclays in the UK, really choosing to leverage this. You've got DBS in Singapore, you've got National Australia Bank in Sydney. So really around the world, we're seeing financial organizations move swiftly to adopt the benefit of AWS in their businesses.
And you were the CTO of Capital One in UK. What are the top lessons that you learn on being CTO moving to the cloud?
Well, I think broadly from both my experience at Capital One and for the customers I've worked with for the last 2 years at Amazon Web Services, I think really the top three lessons learned, if I was going to crystallize them, would be have a really clear business goal of what you want to achieve. Have the leadership team really understand the principles to enable that in their business. Don't just treat cloud as a project. If you really want to get the maximum benefit out of it, treat it as how are you going to really benefit this across your business. And then fourthly, really focus on reskilling your teams to get the most out of cloud and try and get to 10% of your employees certified with AWS. At that point, you find the common language of AWS cloud becomes prolific in your business. Your teams will start collaborating, sharing ideas on how to go really fast. So there are the three or four top lessons, both from my own experience and for those I've worked with around the world.
Are data protection and privacy still a very big issue for banks when moving to the cloud, or do you think regulations as GDPR have helped them to make this move?
I see regulation as an enabler. So if you look at AWS cloud, our systems are GDPR compliant. You know, banks have a lot of overhead of maintaining SOC 1, SOC 2, SOC 3, PCI compliance. When you look at AWS and leverage the AWS systems, you can leverage our own status and compliance of those. You can log in, you can get to those accreditations, those certifications that we have, and reducing your burden of regulation when you move forward. And it can be extreme, you know, for financial organizations to be regulated. So easing that burden is one of the primary reasons we see actually customers coming to AWS Cloud.